Hey guys, today I'll show you how you can test your apps online on a number of different devices for free. Well, if you are an app developer like me, then you know the importance of app testing. App testing is necessary to optimize our apps for different screen sizes and different Android or iOS versions. But generally, we don't have that many devices to test our apps, so we take help from friends and colleagues. But not always we find the right device with the right platform. And hence the idea of online app testing comes in. Yeah, there are platforms that allow us to test our apps on multiple devices. But most of them require paid subscription. So today, I'm going to share with you a totally free method to test our apps online. My name is Ritesh Prasad and you are watching OS Busters. So let's get started. If you are an experienced developer, then you may have heard about Google's Firebase platform, which offers lots of useful tools and features to developers for free. Some of its very useful features include database, storage, authentication, analytics, etc. And yes, you guessed it right. It also provides facility to test our apps as well. So let's open Firebase and check how we can do that. Well, if you haven't used Firebase before, then you first have to create a project to access its features. So let's click on Add Project. Let's give it a name. I'll name it App Testing. You may edit the project ID according to your wish, but it should be unique. So I'll leave it like that. Now we'll click on I accept the control terms. And then click create project. Now here you can access all the project features. But before moving further, let me tell you something. Although Firebase provides almost all the important features to the free users, but there are some limitations. One of such limitations is that we can create limited number of projects. However, there is nothing clearly stated in the Firebase documentation about how many projects free users can create. But according to some reports, it ranges from 5 to 10. Now, let's check out the test lab where we can test our apps. So as you can see here, there is option for both Android and iOS. For Android, we can directly upload our APK for testing. But for iOS, we have to create XCTest in Xcode to test the app here. So let's try the test lab and see how it works. So we upload an APK. It may take some time. So it's finally uploaded. And now it is automatically running the first test on a Pixel device. But we can also test the app on the device of our choice. So for that, let's click on the create a new test. So as you can see here, it provides different options to test our apps, different ways. There's Robo test, instrumentation test, game loop, and in iOS there's a simple one test, that is XCTest. So in Robo test, it will automatically provide a bot to test our apps. Yeah, we can also upload a script, our own handwritten script, to make robot do something we want. And then there is instrumentation test, where we can run Espresso, Robotium or uiautomator code to test our apps. And then another one is game loop, where we have to write a script in the manifest of our app so that it will run a specific task in the app in loop. And we can also set when the loop should end. So this is it. We'll go with the robot test here. We click on continue. Now we have to browse our APK file. We simply upload the same one we uploaded before. Again, it will take some time. It's uploaded finally. Here, as you can see, there's an option for Robo script as well. If you want, we can upload our own Robo script, but we'll go with the default one. So let's click on continue. As you can see here, there are so many physical devices with different SDK version. There are also many virtual devices here as well. As you can see, it contains all types of devices, from tablets to latest big screen phones like Samsung Galaxy S9 Plus, and so many other devices are there with latest Android versions. So there won't be much problem with testing our app in different platforms here. But there is something that I would like to tell. As you can see here, you have a daily quota of 5 physical and 10 virtual device test executions. That means for free users, you can run only 15 tests. So this is it. To get more tests a day, we have to buy the paid subscription. However, the limit is enough for a simple developer. And yes, there are many other options, like here orientation. You can choose different orientation for your app. If we choose both orientations, like landscape and portrait, it will run both the orientations, but it will count it as two device tests, because in two orientations testing. So take a note of that as when you test. And we have some advanced options as well. In advanced options, we can set our test timeout, test duration from here. And if our apps require login, then we can fill these fields with our login credentials. So this is it. We can save the template from here so that we don't have to choose again the same device. So then we'll click on start one test. We have selected the portrait version, so let's click it. In pixel 2, it is being tested. One test, the previously running test has been passed. Let's check that out. So let's go back to the test lab. So this test has been passed. This test will take around 5 to 10 minutes. So we can't wait that much for this video. So let's check this one out first. As you can see here, it's showing green tick. That means the testing was successful. Our app passed the test. And if you get a red cross, that means your app crashed during the test. So you need to take a note of that. However, you'll find all the information if you click on this button. So let's check the results. So it's showing all the crawl graph, what it did with the app, everything you get to know from here, with arrows from which screen it went to which screen, like that. Then from logs, you can get all the app log when app was running. then screenshots. So under screenshots, you'll find screenshots of the app taken during the test. So as you can see here, there are so many screenshots here. Not only this, you'll also get the full video of the whole process here. When we run it, it will show how our app was running, how it worked simply. So this is showing the whole process where Robo clicked, how it did interact with the app. And there we have a performance tab. So under performance tab, we get all the performance related data here, all the analytics, everything, how the CPU was running, memory, network. Here we have also video for different actions. We can simply click on the position and we'll get to the directly on that point when the robot did these tasks. So this is it. And you can download all these results if you click on this button, test results. It will open Google Cloud Platform. Here you will find all the things from video to logcat, from in artifacts you'll get the screenshots and some other files. So everything you can download from here on your PC. So this is how you can test your apps for free by using Firebase console. I hope this video helped you in your app development. Please give a like if you found this video helpful. Thanks for watching.